Right, Aki Kareem here, BBTV. I'm here with young James Dean Fury. We're in Congleton at Team Fury Setup. James Dean, just ticking away since I last seen you, but you've got a fight coming up. Tell us about this.
Yeah, I'm just in the gym, training away, working hard towards September the 9th on Gary Dome Show. That's about 3 weeks away, so I'm working hard for that and get a nice big win in.
Now, your Uncle Peter's told me I've got to film that.
Yeah.
So you've got nowhere to hide now.
Get it filmed, get the fight posted straight on YouTube, be good.
Are you enjoying it? Are you enjoying that sort of stuff? Are you enjoying getting regular bouts and everything like that?
Of course I am, you know. I can't wait to next year. There'll be loads of championships on and stuff. I'm just going to get as many fights as I can in this year. And next year, there'll be loads of box cups and championships on. Enter all and win them all. And just keep going from there, Aki.
Good man, good man. Well, obviously, we've come down here to see your uncle talking about AJ and Fury, AJ and Hellenius, the fight. Did you watch it?
I watched a clip of it, I never watched the full fight. I only seen the seventh round where he knocked him out. So I haven't got much to say about that because I only seen a little clip of it.
I was speaking to Huey there and I said, look, if you'd got the call, would you have jumped in? He said, yeah. Would you have liked to have seen something like, would you like to have seen that?
Yeah, of course I would. It would have been a good cracking fight for sure. I reckon Huey would have come on top of that fight, definitely.
What do you make of Huey at the minute? Because he said he's getting a few things sorted out medical-wise and then he's going to be back at some point.
Yeah, he's going to get a few things sorted out. You know, he's training and he'll be back. I don't know about this year or next year, definitely back out next year anyway.
Yeah, yeah. A couple new lads in the gym as well. One that looked roughly around your size, so some new sparring for you?
Yeah, a good bit of sparring. Yeah, he comes down once a week or twice a week. There's that young lad that comes here, that just went out.
Yeah.
You know, there's Will, obviously Savannah and April. Savannah's having a break off, isn't she?
Yeah, what are they up to at the minute, Savannah and April? They're off travelling, is that right? Or they've been travelling?
I don't know what they're doing. I know April's coming down. April was here all last week. She ain't been here this morning, but April's back in training, yeah.
Yeah, it's an interesting one because you're only 17. I keep forgetting that, you know, because you sort of come across a bit older than that.
Yeah.
But you're only 17, so you've got a long way to go, haven't you?
Got a long way to go. I'm on the ladder, am I? On the way to the top, you know. But it's all learning and all experience for me, you know. It's good because I'm only 17 and I'm learning off the best, you know. I thought, if I can't improve here and get better here, where am I going to get better at? Nowhere, you know. So remember my name, James Dean Fury. I'm coming straight to the top. Believe me. Trust me.
Yeah. What's the plan? I know we've talked a little bit about this in the past, though, but like you're thinking about maybe 20, turning over at maybe 20, 21 or something like that.
Turning over at 20, yeah. I'm going to get as many amateur fights as I can, impossible. Win as many things and get that many amateur fights in, and then turn over at 20-year-old.
Tell us about the amateur circuit then, because you know you have a lot of amateur fights. You're fighting quite good competitive fights every time you fight. They're normally 50-50 fights. It's not like when you get in your pros, your first 10 fights, you're getting journeyman, etc.
That's what it is when the amateur fight, because obviously everyone wants to win. We're all young boys, you know what I mean? We all want to take each other's head off. So that's what it is. Even if they're no good or not, they're still in there to win, and they're going to try their best. And it's 3 rounds, it's only a sprint. 3 rounds, you can fucking hold your breath for 3 rounds, you know what I mean? It's,
Can you hold your breath that long?
No, but it's just a figure of speech, you know? But, what it is, everyone wants to win. You're all young boys and that there, and obviously when you turn over, there's journeymen that's in there to survive, aren't they? And there's someone that wants to win and someone that wants to survive, but in the amateurs, everyone wants to take your head off and it's all 50-50 fights.
Do people, when they sort of see your surname and everything, when you're in the amateurs, do they get a bit riled up to fight you?
I don't really know, to be honest. Some will, some like will want to fight you, just to say to beat the Fury. And then some of them will avoid you because you are Fury, you know what I mean? But I don't think that makes a difference. I think what it is now, let's say, yeah, I'm a Fury, but if I don't put the hours in the gym and I don't train, I'm going to get my head punched in. But it doesn't matter who your family is. But I win because I'm in the gym, training hard, dedicated, and listening to what my Uncle Peter's telling me. That's why I win, and that's why I'm doing what I'm doing.
Yeah, well, I have, the only reason I ask is because I had the same conversation with Campbell Hatton when he was in the amateurs, and then when he turned over, and there was quite a lot of pressure, you know, pressure on him. You know, obviously you've got very famous relatives, you know, currently boxing at the top of their game, you know, Tyson, Huey. You know, the full family is just doing it, basically.
Yeah, what it is, though, it's Huey and Tyson's Tyson. You know, they've done what they've done. They've put all the hard work in all these years, you know. And I'm 17-year-old and I'm coming up and I'm going to do it. you know, because over what Tyson used on that doesn't mean I'm automatically there, and I'm automatically a champion, and I'm automatically very good. You've got to work towards it.
Mm. Yeah.
You've got to work hard, and you've got to get there. You've got to put the hours in the gym. You've got to eat right. You've got to live right as well.
Yeah, yeah. And when I first met you, you were sort of like, you weren't as professional as you are now. You was very young, and you was just
a young kid. I've been with Minkopedia since being 13, 14 year old.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I've gone from just walking to a boxing gym. Obviously, I'd done a bit of boxing when I was like 12 or something, but nothing major, just doing what I was doing, wanted to do what I wanted to do. But since I've been with Minkopedia, I've done it properly. I've won national titles, you know what I mean? I've won a national title. And I've done things properly.
Yeah.
And I've improved, and I've built in confidence. I've got a lot of confidence, you know. I'm better. Obviously, I'm going to get better because I'm listening, I'm dedicated, I'm doing what I'm doing. So I'm going to get there.
I think you've given your uncle as well something, you know, long term to look at as well, because I know he's got a small stable and he wants to keep it that way. But I think when he speaks about you, it's almost like, you know, he's got a, you know, something that he, you know, promised your old man and everything like that, and it's quite personal to him, isn't it?
Of course it is, yeah, because I'm his brother's grandson. Mm. You know, he's, it's good because he's my family, and I won't listen to anyone else but my family, you know? If I'm not going to listen to my family, I'm not going to listen to anybody, you know? So, I'm in the right place.
Do you sort of hear some of that, you know, the old, like, obviously from a traveller background, do you hear like some of the old stories from back in the day? Is that dying down a bit more now with this generation coming through?
I hear a lot about stories back in the day, you know, from when my granddad was around my age, my uncle Peter was around my age and all up there. I've heard loads of stories, you know, from when I was all young and I don't know.
Do you enjoy hearing that? Like looking at your culture and your heritage?
I can sit and listen to all the people talk about years ago for hours. I could sit there, right? I could sit with Uncle Peter there and I could chat to him all day about stories he's telling me from years ago. I could sit there all day.
Yeah.
Have a sandwich and a cup of tea and just watch him.
I love that, you know, because it's something that in the modern generation, you know, there's all these, there's phones and there's you know, distractions, and I don't really think young generation talk as much.
No, they don't, but I think because they can't talk as much, there's nothing to talk about. You know what I mean? But I've listened to all my granddad's brothers, but about stories from years ago.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? My granddad's told me stories, and his brothers.
Yeah.
They've told me stories from years ago, and it's very interesting.
Yeah.
And I do listen to it. I sit there for hours and just listen to them.
From the Fury family history, other other families as well, so from your breed, like, you know, the Gormans,
yeah,
etc. like that.
I've heard stories about them all, yeah.
Yeah.
They could all fight. They're all fighting men.
It's great. It's fascinating. It's fascinating. I suppose it gives you good motivation as well to have that culture from the background to fight.
It does, yeah. Of course it does. You know, it's good to have a background like that. You know, you can just look back and ask your elders about this person or that person, and it's good.
Well, you're coming along great, James Dean. It's great to see you keeping going. It's great to see you getting matched up regularly. And if you want to see James Dean in action, I'll be filming this fight on September the 9th.
September the 9th, yeah.
So you'll be able to see it September the 10th on the channel. And, there we go. Good man. Anything you want to say?
Yeah, I'm coming. Watch out. James Dean Fury. Coming right to the top.
Good man. Speak to you next time.
See you next time, Mikey. Thank you.